Hey guys, in this video we're going to take you through taking a culture from a mushroom that you have found in the wild, if you want to bring it back and get that culture onto a petri dish. So it was Christmas for me today. I was at my old man's house. He's got quite a big piece of land, and I was having a hunt around, and I found this beautiful patch of Shaggy Mane, and some of them were like the height of my head plus some, about that fat, like your thigh. These are big Shaggy Manes, and so I took some of the smaller ones which hadn't started dissolving themselves, and I've got them home here, and so we're going to try and get a culture off them and get that culture onto a petri dish so we can grow it in the future. These are some nice specimens of Shaggy Manes. You can see the Sharpie there for size. The big ones I saw today were probably about five times the size of that. Some of them went way out to here, just these enormous things, but they were already half digested. So I got these ones here so I could get them home. Yeah, they're really quite something. The field I saw was really large. So we'll definitely be returning to that field again after a bout of rain to see if we can get some more. But anyway, we're going to try and get some cultures from these. So I've got my workspace ready. I've got two pre-made petri dishes of agar which I'm going to use. I've got a sterile scalpel I'm going to use. And I've got my mushrooms which I collected today, and we'll get one of those out and we'll use them now. Now, this obviously isn't sterile in any capacity, but the inside of its stem will be sterile. So what I'm going to do, and the way you do it is you rip open the stem to expose that inner flesh. We're going to take a sample from down here and up the top, and when you rip open that stem to expose the inner flesh with the sterile scalpel, you want to cut a piece of that flesh out and move that onto the sterile petri dishes. Now, you don't want to use the scalpel and cut, because as soon as the scalpel touches the outside, that blade's no longer sterile. That's why we rip it open. So you rip it open to expose the sterile flesh, and then you get your sterile scalpel and try and cut out the centre. Now, it is tricky, obviously, because the mushroom itself, by all means, is not sterile in any capacity. There's actually dirt and garbage all over it. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to try and get the top off that. Perfect. And that can go aside. I could actually probably eat that for dinner just quietly. There we are. That's one. Cool it in the agar. Make sure you're always working behind your plate. I'm going to go back to here. Right, that's good. Here we go. So you can also take a sample from up inside here, but that's quite difficult with Shaggies because they are predominantly all gills. So there's almost all gill and a very thin line of the outside wall.
So it's been about a week now. We'll head inside and we'll see if those samples I took from the Shaggy Mane mushroom have started to grow mycelium. You're not going to believe what happened. It worked. Hallelujah. 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 We have a new Shaggy Mane culture. You can see the mycelium growing off the parts of the stem I cut off and placed in there.
Once that mycelium's grown out a bit further, I'll cut the leading edges off and transfer them to new petri dishes, and that'll hopefully isolate the mycelium away from any potential bacteria that could be around these stalk or the areas that I'd cut off and placed in the middle there.